The apprehension of screaming through Bray Hill probably hits you just here. In top gear down here. Awesome! Over the infamous Aggersley. Through the 1 mile marker. Early on the brakes for quarter bridge. You need to brake in good time or you'll be on the way to the airport. It's very easy to make a silly mistake here. A short straight to Braddon. A tricky S-bend left-right. Then past the 2 mile marker. Got to work hard on the entry. Absolutely flat out. Driving down through Union Mills. The close walls either side make this seem a lot quicker. And past the petrol station at Union Mills. Passing through the 3 mile marker. Then the long climb up the Ballahutchin to Glenvine. A tricky corner, so down a couple of gears. If you wheelie out of Ballagarry, you know you've done a good job. At the 4 mile marker. Up over Crosby. A very fast bend. You can relax a moment just after here. Downhill through the Highlander. Passing the 5 mile marker. Down through Grieber Castle. Riding very hard into Grieber Castle. Back on the gas through Appledean. Past the 6 mile marker. Down through Beaver Bridge to the Hawthorns. This hump can unsettle you if you're too hard on the gas. Past the 7 mile marker onto Ballacrane. Where George Formby supposedly ran into the pub. There's not much room for overtaking from Ballaspur because it's all rights and left until Glen Helen. And top gear down towards Ballaig. Across the bridge. Back a gear for this one. Named after Bill Doran, a TT regular until 1953. Then a long left right into Laurel Bank itself. A slow right-hander. At the 9 mile marker. a quarter of the way round. A long climb up towards Sarah's. A slow right-hander proceeding a mile and a half of flat-out riding. A real twisty climb on Fred Willis Hill. Passing the 10-mile marker. With a slight jump as you burst out through the trees. Pulling top gear along there. And cocky body crossroads, then a very fast right-hander. Long pass right. Flat out after here, then into handlers. Slowing down a bit for Handley's corner. Named after Walter Handley, a famous rider who was killed in World War II. The left, right, left towards the top of Barrichello. Over the crossroads. Then on to the 13th milestone. A big left. On towards Douglas Road. Braking hard and down a couple of gears. Should be in top gear now into Kirkmichael. This is what makes the Isle of Man special, going flat out through the village. Passing the 15-mile mark on the exit. We see a lot of wheelies over the rise. A favourite spot for many riders. In top gear down towards Bishop's Court. Be a bit damp under the trees. A fast left-right exit. Through 16 miles. Long, fast, smooth right-hander. Miles down through the gears and a jump on the way in. Hard on the gas out of this one. Past Gwen, the lady in white, she just lives for motorcycling. A very fast bend indeed. Big jump out of this one, just before Quarry Bends. Screaming past the 18-mile marker. Big bikes usually hook back a gear to steady it up for this. Fast right, left, right, left. Halfway round the course. At the 90-mile marker. You can relax a bit on this long straight section. At 20 miles, a slow right bend, and the power piles on again here, a slow Sulby Bridge corner, up over the top towards Carrow Moor. Now a very bumpy section all the way to Ramsey. You can gain a lot of time here if you get the sequence right. Over the jump, on the exit, for Glenduff. Just past the 21 mile marker, then a fast left. Hard on the brakes approaching Glen Tramon. Through a right-hander with severe adverse camber. At 22 miles. A bumpy right-hander into Milltown. Then past the 23-mile marker. Past the Fuelhouse corner, a fast 90-degree left. Just before Parliament Square, into Ramsey. It's quite slippy here because of all the normal traffic. Really bumpy on the way out of this one. Where the climb begins. Past 24 miles. Then left into Whitegate. Another second gear corner. Named after the house whose drive has received a few wayward riders. Just before the hairpin. A lot of braking because it's a very tight left. A slowish right and then a slower right. Through tower bends, right and left and onto the mountain section. 25-mile marker. The gooseneck is like a short circuit corner, really. You need a good line through all these fast corners. try and treat these three left-handers as one. After this, you try to get your head down for the mountain mile. Only 27 miles around the course. Flat out in top gear along here. It can be really windy up there. This is where the fog comes down. You can take a bit of a breather along there. Quite a long section. Keep tucked in as tight as you can along here. It's supposed to be a straight, but at 180 miles an hour, those slight bends become a lot bigger. Passing the 28 mile mark. Passing the three-quarter way post. They need to watch out for those crosswinds. Just past the 29 mile mark. Fair dip going past the hut. A long left approaching the veranda. This has four corners that you take as one. Then the 30 mile mark. You treat this one with a lot of caution. Named in memory of Les Graham, who crashed in the 1953 Senior TT at the bottom of Grey Hill just hours after winning the ultra-lightweight race the day before. A great spectator spot here. Under the footbridge, then hard on the gas. Uphill now towards Brandywell at 31 miles. Top gear as you head towards Brandywell. Back a few gears into Brandywell. Start of the mountain descent. Just before the 32 mile mark. At the 32 mile mark. Trap there if you get into trouble. A really fast approach to the 33rd, then onto the 33 mile marker. The 33rd, like the 32nd, is one of the two most difficult corners on the circuit. Down a couple into this hard-braking left-hander. The road falls away quite a bit here. Down towards a steep hill. Down towards the crag. At the 34-mile point. Hard on the brakes into the crag. Probably the best spectating spot outside of Douglas. Absolutely flat out. Just before hard braking into Brandish. Down a few into this one. named after Walter Brandish, who broke his leg here in practice for the 1923 TT, which ended his racing career. Really fast through here. A fast right-hand exit. At 36 miles, you take all these corners in one. Cronk Nemona ends with a blind crest. Second gear round here. A very slow, tight bend. Then dive down the hill through Bedstead. Quite a tricky corner. Give it just a bit of gas down towards the nook. Down lots of gears. A tricky hairpin. Then a little left right before the straight. Back down Glen Country Road. Screaming down here if you're on a flying lap.